A couple of traditional procedures are called a lobectomy and a total thyroidectomy. And you have an image, and you're going to walk us through how these two procedures are done.
Every operation has three priorities: cure, safety, cosmesis, in that order. I sometimes have the debate with my patients. They'd like to reverse the order on
me. Right, they'd like cosmetic first.
Right, but once we have the serious conversation, yes, you have a cancer or a potential cancer, and yes, there are other structures in the neighborhood like the nerves to your vocal cords, and yes, if I need a quarter inch more skin incision to do a safe operation, that's what I'm gonna do, and either you're on board with me or you're not, but we gotta make this contract up front so we're on the same page. Mm-hmm. Nobody turns me down.
Of course not.
But we have that conversation. So you make the incision, and it's generally a small incision. We try to find a natural skin crease to make it so it looks good. We have to get past these muscles. These are the strap muscles in the midline. We move those to the side. So during routine thyroid surgery, we only cut one muscle called the platysma. The platysma is a very thin muscle. It's only in the neck in humans. In horses, it's throughout their body. If you've ever been on a horse and they shake their skin to get the flies off in the mm-hmm. summertime, that's the platysma they're shaking. So horses have platysmas throughout their bodies. Humans only have it in their neck.
Okay.
You know, see this? Mm-hmm. That's the platysma when it goes up like that. It's this very small, very thin muscle. We cut that and we put it back together. So we get these muscles out of our way, so to get to the thyroid gland. And then it's not shown well. This is actually the thyroid cartilage, but below it, here's this, the top of the thyroid gland that we can see. And my incisions, by the way, aren't this big. And then we get down to the thyroid gland itself. And we have a choice to make. How much do you remove? Do you remove one side? Do you remove both sides?
Right. And that's a decision you make while you're
in the operating room.
In the operating room.
And here's an example where this patient has a nodule over here. This patient could probably just have had this lobe removed, but the surgeon elected to remove the thyroid lobe and the central portion called the pyramidal lobe and the isthmus. You have choices to make in the operating room. That's mm-hmm. a pretty small nodule. And then you can have a total thyroidectomy where at the end of the operation, there's no thyroid tissue left at all. So surgeons have that discretion in the operating room. And another conversation I have with my patients, which is typical, is, look, I'm going to go in there and I plan to do a lobe, but I ask you to consent for more than that. A lobe, a possible total, a possible central lymph node dissection, because when I'm in that operating room and I see something I don't know about yet, I will discover it. I want your permission to do the right thing now, because the last thing I want to go out is during the middle of an operation and talk to your loved one and ask them to allow me to do more than we talked about up front. And everybody says, of course.